Let us start concept of object-oriented programming. In last video, we used class and understand class. Actually, class solves both of our problems. First problem was creator of the main thing in the term of integer, which has been solved by class. Using class, creator of main thing in term of point. Because main is declaring a variable of type point, not of type integer. Other problem we had, if there is any change in data type, then main has to take care about that change. But class solved this second problem also. Okay. Now main do not care about we are working on 2D or we are working on 3D or we are working on 4D or etc. Main only care about point and that's it. How it comes to know, let us go to our last program. This is our program which we already understood in the last video. Let's change this program and add an extra variable z. This program is working on 2D. Now let us start working on 3D. This class, first you remember, this class has been created by someone else. Okay, because in real life example, you do not have so simple program. You have to divide your work and say someone else to create a class about point. And that someone will take care of any change in the point. You as a user, main as a user, should not be take care about any change. Okay. So think this section, this added section, as created by someone else, not created by main. Okay. This has been created by someone else. Someone else created it and given to me. Now, let us change this program to work on 3D. To work on 3D, I have to add an extra integer int z. Okay? See, you notice the change where we are changing. Then, we have to change set data to yyp. Actually 2yy is copy command in vi editor, so you don't confuse about this. We have to change in get data section also. Then there is a add section here also have to be changed, and this all changes are done by that person who has given me this point data type. Okay, think this is not going to change by me. These changes are going to be that person who has created the point data type. Okay. So make it z. That's all. We are ready to start working on three-dimensional point. Has we changed anything inside main? No. We didn't change a single character inside main. Main is same as what it was when we was working on 2D. There is nothing going to be changed inside main. Main is the user of this data type. This is the data type and main is the user. User data, user code is not going to change anyhow. Only going to change is the data type, because all the functions also belong to data type. So change in function is responsibility of creator of data type, because these functions belong to data type only. So change in these functions are responsibility of creator of data type, not user of data type. So user of data type is completely free of any change in the data type. Okay, and this freeness of user of the data type comes because of object based programming. Okay, why I'm not saying about object oriented programming, because we will see later, but think it as object based programming. If user of a class do not aware of any changes of the class inside the class, then this type of programming is called object based programming. Okay, so from procedural programming we entered into object based programming. In next video we will see some object oriented concepts and their definitions. Bye for now.